Aha, there we go. Praise the God. Praise the God again. Oh, it's been a minute. Happy to be back, and I'm back with a question. Why are you watering dead plants? Why are you watering dead plants? Why have you been in the one in charge of watering dead relationships? If you don't call them, they won't call you. If you don't text them, they don't text you. If you don't WhatsApp them, they don't remember to WhatsApp you. If you don't Facebook them, they don't Facebook you. If you don't visit them, they don't have plans. And you know, there are people who have done this for long without noticing that there's an imbalance. I am one of them. I don't, it takes me really such a really long time to notice that there's something. Because I'm a lover. When I love, I love, I don't see, I'm a lover. People think you're stupid out here. Hey, you know, it's painful that you've been the one visiting someone. You know, I have a feeling that when you leave, they laugh at you. I have a feeling. Kai, that is painful. Chai, yani me, I'm busy loving you for free. And you are busy seeing a fool out. Ay, Father. May you be delivered. I got delivered. May you be delivered. In fact, the only I know many of you that if you stopped calling today, your phone won't work. If you stop texting, because you are the one who is making your phone work. If you put it down, nobody's gonna call you. They won't text you. They won't WhatsApp you. You're the one following them. Oh, mpango leo tunaenda kukunywa wapi? What's the plot today? You're the one always asking for the plot. It's high time you save your energy and buy your own plot. Because if you don't ask, they just move on with their life. See, God created every human being with a desire for fellowship. So if they're not fellowshipping with you, yeah, that's right. They're fellowshipping with someone else. If they're not visiting you, they're visiting someone else. If they're not calling you, they're calling elsewhere. If they're not texting you, yeah, that's right. If they're not WhatsApping you, that's right. Why are you putting yourself in a belittling position? Is it because you're less of a human being? What is it? What is it? Are you less of a human being that you have to act like burnt offering with your friends? You have to be the one paying the sacrifice, sacrificing yourself for this relationship. Ah, no. A relationship without balance is unhealthy. It has to have a balance. It has to be mutual. You call me, I call you. You love me, I love you. You text me, I text you. You see me, I see you. There are people who, if you don't ask to see them, you'll never see them. Because they're not in a hurry to see you. They're seeing other people. What are you waiting for? Tarumbeta. The life we have is so short. You see, the way our friends are dying left, right, and center. They are dying morning, day, morning. Our friends are dying. And you are still here using the remaining privilege of time in your life to be chasing after people. Why? Are you less of a human being? Are you not chaseable? No, find your tribe. People that appreciate you in their life. People that are honored that you're their friend. They honor your time. They take your time seriously. You know, they honor your presence. They pull their weight in the friendship, relationship, whatever it is. It's okay. Yeah, if some family, some cousins feel like they're the celebrity cousins, they're the VIP cousins. We don't have to talk every day. We are still families flying from a distance. I'm telling you. And we will still go to heaven. By the way. Don't anybody intimidate you and say, that's not. No, we will still go to heaven. Yeah. But a balance is key. It's priority. Your personal peace is priority. Because if you don't take care of your personal peace by chasing people that obviously do not want to pull equal weight in this relationship, you're going to end up bitter and angry and hurting. Who has time for you to become a motivational speaker here on Facebook? We don't have time. So that you don't become a motivational speaker for nothing, just stop presenting yourself, exposing yourself, you know, placing yourself in positions where someone is going to belittle you. Nobody should belittle you. You are a full complete. Did I just say complete? Complete. Hey, nimekuandikia na movie mingi. Complete. You are a full, complete person worthy of every ounce of love and appreciation and effort and consistency. Okay, you deserve it all that, honey. Plus a cherry on top. So nobody should be serving you things like you're not a, you're less of a human being. No, you're not. You're a complete. Allow me to just. You're a complete human being, my friend, who deserves what, who is worthy of every ounce of love, appreciation, honor, respect, equally. Yeah? Natoki katono ni kanga matono ni yath. Opi mo ni kwani what? What? Why? Because. Duh. No. No. If you think I'm lying, try today. Try stopping to call them. Oh, the phone won't ring because. Try stopping to text them, honey. Try stopping to WhatsApp them. Pinyo. That's when you will know you've been watering dead plants. You've been busy watering dead relationships. Things that are not there. They're wondering, ay, Kwani, you don't get it. You don't get it. Ay, Father, don't wait to that point. It's very bad. Hey, do you know how discrimination is bad? You've been discriminated based on poverty, based on sickness. The people who think, hey, mgonjwa sana, they're too much. And then you also, you know, things like poverty or umesota, that's why your friends, you know, shun you and close you out, are okay because you can't help that. But positions where you are the one that deliberately, intentionally presents yourself to be belittled, stop it. Hey, stop watering dead plants. As you move on, God will orchestrate and plan friends that bring equal energy in your relationship and friendship. You don't have to die with people that don't want you in their space. No. No.